Hi, thank you for joining us on this video. We're going to cover how to customize your ConexED card and some of the cool tricks that you can do and really be more accessible to your students. So first, we're here at the Student Services page, and we can see that I'm logged in, so I can see myself up here. I am offline. I can change my status if I'd like to. I can set an away and then also put in a message right here. I'm going to hit cancel and be offline so no one knocks on my door. A lot of people ask, why are my options grayed out? And it's because you cannot send yourself an offline message or register for a workshop or schedule a meeting with yourself. So it will look like this to you, but it will be different to other people. See, Heather, I can send offline message, click on the workshop button and schedule a meeting with her. So others will see these active, but you cannot do that with yourself, and that's why it's grayed out. To navigate to your customization card, you can go right here to this up top area and click on that, or you can click on the customize card. So there's two areas where you can access this area and customize your ConexED card. You should select a photo. That should be the first thing you need to do. And it shouldn't be like an icon or a logo. It really should be your picture. The students will need to identify you either when they go into the office or when they connect with you in Cranium Cafe in your in-office video area. So selecting a photo is what you want to do first. And you want to make sure that it's a square photo and not too large of a file size. So that's the trick, to not have it pixelated. It should be maybe 200 by 200. Put your name, what you want your students, you know, to call you by and know you by, and then the title, your email address. You can allow offline messaging. If you select that or if you deselect it, it will gray out that send offline message button. So you can decide if you want that option. Basically, this will just go directly to your email. It's kind of nice because the student has to log in to their ConexED account before they send an offline message to you. And if you have a group card creation and you have the informed consent, they have to accept the informed consent to send that offline message. So it's better than just sending an email because they have to log in, and then they also have to accept the informed consent. You can put your phone, but of course you can make everything visible and not visible. Like right over here, make your email visible to others or your phone number. So right here are those options. I have everything allowed. So actually I'm gonna click on allow offline message. I'm gonna remove that. I'm going to remove, make my email visible and make my phone number, you know, visible. So that's going to be removed. I'm going to preview my card, and right now it does have it visible. When I hit save, so I need to save it first to actually activate these options. So always remember to hit save. So right now people can see my phone number, they can see my email, but if you use a send on offline message, you don't have to list your email. It will go directly to your email. So I'm going to hit close and I'm going to hit save. And now what we're going to do is preview the card and see those options if they're removed. And they are. So now my phone number, even though it's listed in my account, people won't see that. Students won't see it. The send on offline message is gone and it won't allow people to use that option. I'm going to hit close and I'm actually going to put those options back because I feel like I want more interaction and I'm okay with that. So I'm going to hit save again and then preview that and then see if those options are back, and they are. So click on bio. This is kind of nice if you want to talk more about yourself and your background and why you have purpose in your school, in what you're doing, in the student services that you're providing, or if you're an instructor, and hit close. Some of the other options that I've added is, you know, my office address, and then I could put these searchable meta tags onto my ConexED card. So anytime I want to save something, hit save, and you can always preview that. Now you can see those really cool meta tags right there. We have extra fields. I added walk-in hours. So if I wanted to have people know my walk-in hours, I just have it included in my ConexED card. So again, let's preview that. It says walk-ins, and there's the walk-in hours. So you can use these fields for anything. If you want to use this for building number, you can customize it the way you want. And then here it is, this building number, this is where I'm located, or whatever you want. But I think walk-in hours, I think it's the best for that. This is my personal lobby message. I can customize this. I can embed a YouTube video. I could put links to download documents or to navigate somewhere else. So when somebody's in my lobby trying to meet with me, this is what they see. They will see this lobby message and they can have more information and access and understand what they're doing while they're waiting to meet me in my cafe. Now, if I was a part of a group, that group lobby message is located in this Campus Calibrate within, let's say the counseling. So I'm included in this counseling group. The administration, a group manager or a department director has the ability to go into this group, go into settings, and customize this group lobby message for the entire group. Here is our group for advising and counseling. Heather and I are together. And so if they knock on my door and they go into the lobby, they'll automatically go to our group lobby because this is the ConexED card integration that has a very specific code that will push them into our group messaging. They'll also see the schedule meeting. This will be our group informed consent, our group scheduling system, all of that. So it can be separate if you're an instructor and you want to use your ConexED card for office hours, for instructor office hours. You can do two separate things, and we could get further into that. If you want more information, I think the best would be one-on-one training so you can really understand that deeper. But so let's go back to the customization. I'm going to click onto this quick hot button up here. And again, this is my personal group lobby message. The groups are different. If I want to embed my card, again, we preview this card, my card alone with my personal scheduling and then my personal lobby, I can embed this card alone. It won't be tied in with a group. So the group cards are very different. This will have my personal card. So it says Tracy Gorham. That is my user data ID. Again, let's go into the group cards because it's significantly different. If I go to counseling and if I go to the group cards and I look at this embed widget, totally different. It pulls from this counseling group. The data right here is the group ID. So if I embed this card, all of the group stuff will be included, like the login, the informed consent, all of the group scheduling system, the group lobby, everything with this group was tied into this code. I can be separate or I can be together as a group. I can use it in dual harmony of both. So, but let's just focus on customizing this card and what your personal ConexED card can do. This ConexED card HTML code, you can add this to a signature, an email signature. Now, it's going to be a picture within the email signature and hyperlink it to your ConexED card where they can knock on the door, schedule offline messaging, all this other fun stuff. But this is a really great embedded image that will be linked directly to your card. So you can generate your card because maybe you change some things and then you want to get that, put it into your email signature. This is the code to do that. If you want to paste it inside a web page or a LMS course, a learning management course, this is the code to do that. So the code, this is JavaScript. You should not use the JavaScript code to put in your email, and vice versa. You should not use the email signature code to put into a web page or a Canvas course. We do have some help topics right here. If you click onto that, it will go to our help, our blog. That is kind of like our help center. And there's always some people online to help you. This will walk you through how to embed your card code and what this all means. But the help center really is good to to, you know, find more information. There's also a help center right here. And if you ever need anybody, just click on the help center. It directs you directly there. And then you can, you know, chat if you need to chat, or if you just want to knock on somebody's door or schedule a one-on-one meeting, please do so. So thank you so much. I appreciate your time.